Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Today's episode is sponsored in part by Highland Woodworking. Visit their website at highlandwoodworking.com. And also by Lee Valley and Veritas. Visit their website at leevalley.com.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop podcast. It's a Tuesday, and of course that means that it's time for Try It Tuesday. And for today's episode, we're going to talk about this little beauty right here. It's the Czeck Edge Ruler-Stop. And you know, I talked about this at about the middle of December, just before we went on our Christmas break. And I really was hoping to get back to it and talk a little bit more, so that's what we're going to do today. Now, this is a nifty little tool that came in, and Bob over at Czeck Edge really came up with something special. I originally was introduced to the prototype of this back at Woodworking America, the St. Charles, Illinois conference, which was the design conference. And I was kind of excited to see this one coming out, especially when Bob got a hold of me and said, hey, you want to try it out? And I'm like, what, are you kidding me? Of course I do. Now, one thing that we really need in every single one of our shops is we need some sort of reliable, repeatable marking gauge. And when it comes down to it, that's pretty much what this is. Now, Bob said himself, it's not going to take the place of a high-quality square, but you know what? It's going to help you do so much that maybe a square either can't do because it's limited with just simply the blade that's attached to it, or you know what, maybe you don't want to use a high-end one and you just want something that is completely adjustable and will fit pretty much whatever task you have. That's where the Czeck Edge Ruler-Stop comes in. So let's take a quick look at this and let's talk a little bit more about the body itself and what it involves, because as you can see, it's this nice little thing. It comes in at about 4 inches in length. It's about an inch wide, and it's about a half inch thick. So to me, it's the perfect size. It's going to fit in my pocket. It's going to fit in my shop apron pockets. I can easily set it on the workbench, and it's not going to take up a lot of space, but it is going to do a lot of tasks for me. Now, it's made of an aircraft-grade aluminum, so it's really lightweight, and it has this really great knurled knob up at the top. And the way that you hold it, it kind of, whenever you see the pictures, you always see it held like this. But in fact, it's held like this because that way you can adjust the knobs up here between your fingers and your thumb, and so you can get whatever it is that you're going to hold in place nice and easy. Just kind of hold it in place right here, and you can spin it. Of course, you can always hold it down here if necessary. But when it comes down to it, this is a really neat tool. Now, one cool thing is, and we'll kind of get a close-up here if possible, you'll notice that the clamping mechanism itself has kind of this vise-like look to it. It has the two grippers that are adjustable. It has a maximum capacity of about 1 1/4 inches. But what I really like is that he has it angled here so that it can hold something really thin, or if necessary, as I'll demonstrate in just a second, you have something just a little bit thicker in there. And it's not just for holding, you know, square stock or rectangular stock. You can actually use this to hold dowels. So again, it adds even more versatility. So let's head over to the workbench. Let's take a look at some of the things we can do with this, because like I said, unlike a square, which can only hold its own blade, with the Czeck Edge Ruler-Stop, it can hold a lot more, which is going to really increase what it can do in your shop for you. So like I said, let's head over there and take a look at a couple of things. Okay, so over here at the bench, you know, like I said, we're all familiar with a square. And when it comes down to it, a high-end square will really, really benefit you in the shop. But unfortunately, there's not much more you can do with it other than just simply the blade that's in here. You can't swap out that blade. There's no way to put a bigger one in. You might be, depending on the manufacturer, be able to put a longer one in, but that's pretty much it. So when it comes down to it, while a high-end square will definitely help you out, there are some limitations to it. You know, there are so many different choices we have when it comes to rulers. I mean, we've kind of, like this one is off of an old square. This is just a centering one that I have sitting around. And I've got a longer one here. And sometimes they have, you know, more increments on them. They have less increments. Maybe it's imperial. Maybe it's metric. And that's where a tool like the Ruler-Stop really comes in handy, because I can take all of these different rules and I just have to open up the jaws enough. Remember, it goes up to about 1 1/4 inches in total width, and I can quickly fit in whichever one I need, so that if perhaps, let's say, this guy right here, I'm not too thrilled with the increments. Maybe I can't read them very well and I want to switch to something more like, you know, this this long guy here because I have a really, really big project that I need to use it on. You know, I want to make a mark further in on a wider piece of plywood. So it's just a matter of adjusting the jaws, putting this in, and then just coming back and, you know, making my my adjustment here. Now, the sides are pretty much dead square on the rule stop. And what this does is, we'll kind of show you here, we'll come in a little bit, and you can easily match up the sides to whatever increment that you want to go with, and you're guaranteed that it's going to be the same at the top and the bottom. So you're guaranteed that your measurement, whatever you're going to use it for, is going to be dead on. So that is a huge benefit in the shop, because having to just simply rely on this to make an accurate square measurement is going to really limit you. But if you have something along the lines of the rule stop, where when you then register it up against the piece, you then know for a fact that it's square here, and all you have to worry about is getting your increments at the right lengths that you want, that is a huge, huge benefit. Now, one thing I like to do quite a bit, and I've talked about this before, is not necessarily relying on rulers like those ones. I mean, like I said, they come in all sorts of different sizes and lengths and in all sorts of different increments. But once in a while, I like to use something that's called a story stick. Now, I'm sure many of you are familiar with story sticks. And what those are just basically homemade shop sticks. And they help to say, you know for a fact that you have a certain length, but you don't want to break out the ruler because, you know, maybe you're just not that good at reading a ruler. Or a lot of times it's just easier transferring those marks onto a stick. Well, you could just take any sort of shape and size here, and it just, because of the clamping action here, we just simply clamp it up on there. You now have, essentially works out to be, a shop-made ruler. You can use this as a story stick so that you can mark those increments on there, and because the sides are nice and square with each other and they're going to be square to the piece, well, you don't have to worry about it, because again, you come in here and you just kind of bump it up there, and wherever your marks are, well, you're going to transfer them to it. Now, of course, like I said, it's 1 1/4 inch total width, so that gives you a lot of room, and it doesn't have to be a thin piece. As you can see with this one, because it has that vise-like jaw in there, this is definitely much thicker than the jaws itself, but they clamp right on, so you don't have to worry about it falling off. Again, that means pretty much any scrap in your shop that's 1 1/4 inches or narrower, you can use it. I have some of this sitting around, which is basically just kind of, you can kind of see there, it's a triangular shape, and I can use this if I wanted to. In fact, I could probably come up with a whole bunch of different plans for using this triangular shape one, and the nice thing is, it fits right in, and again, you can kind of see it there. The jaws have that little lip on it to make sure that it holds it in place. Now, one more that I want to show you is that you can even use round stock, and this one, you're kind of limited a little bit, not much. I tried it with a much wider one. I would say about, it was probably about 3/4 to 1 inch thick, but it kind of fell off. But as you can see with this one, with narrower on, you then have, again, a whole bunch of range of options for story sticks or whatever sort of measurement you're going to make. It makes working in your shop a lot easier rather than having to constantly think about, oh, now it needs to be 1 1/4 inches deep, or it needs to be 1 5/16 or whatever. Using a story stick and using the rule stop really, really helps out. Of course, I still use with my ruler constantly. One thing I just noticed when I was setting this up is I could use this in a certain situation much like I would a compass. Now, you're probably thinking, well, you're really kind of stretching on this one. And yeah, I am a little, but I mean, the nice thing is that rule stop clamps right in there, and then I just simply take a piece, and that's what I have the screw in here for, and I can just hold on to it. Now, I don't know if I would be doing this for an absolute dead accurate measurement. I can if I take the time really to play around with it, but to just get something roughed out so that I have an idea of what I'm working with, this would really work great. In fact, you know what? I probably could get a dead on one. I would just have to come in here and clamp it. So let's bring the camera down just a little bit. I'm going to show you this. I thought this was just pretty neat. All right, so I've got the rule stop, and I've got a little pencil marked in there. Like I said, I've got my little piece of scrap here with a screw through it, and let's just do this. Let's just make a little arc here. So I'm just going to push that down, kind of hold it in place, and then to help me get a really nice tight grip on this, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring in this clamp. simply clamp it on there. And like I said, this is just kind of a rough thing just to see what we can do. And let's see.